Welcome back to Let's Play Tacoma. I'm blind. I'm the RPG chick. We're about to go in the special AI door where the wetware is. So strange, I have to face towards certain things just to hear them. But yeah, we keep seeing these signs, right? A sign just for me. Attention subcontractor Ferrier, AI wetware. Access this way. And yeah, it's just hanging open. Wait. No walking. AI. Tenured ventures, corporate employees only beyond this point. Contractors face severe penalties for trespassing. Mission parameters, permission override. Access granted. Subcontractor Amy Ferrier. Please proceed. So, just to, refresh.
Odin, is this it?
That is the loop.
You're there? You're gonna need a crowbar or something.
No, it's open.
Yep.
It's just hanging open.
What?
I must inform you that crew members direct access to AI hardware. But I cannot prevent you from proceeding.
Matt, I'm going in.
Okay, I'm just...
AI Secure Communications Center. Data accessed by authorized Ventura's personnel only. So excited. Our path is being lit. Hello, Odin. Captured 12 hours ago. Illegal data access by crew member Sarah Hazmati 14 hours ago. She just came in here and did that. Ditto. Ditto. Review data. AI secure communications record. Off-station message with confidential. Tacoma rescue craft launch schedule. T-minus 01 hours 26 minutes. Confidential again. Tacoma rescue craft launch canceled. Relaunch scheduled for. Relaunch unscheduled. Great. Message with VT AI handler account 717. The rescue craft departure has been intentionally canceled? Yes. Without a rescue craft, the crew will expire from lack of oxygen or cryosleep overexposure within 12 hours. Unfortunately, circumstances outside your concern make this unavoidable. AI may not reopen comms to contact orbital craft or facilities. AI may not provide crew with confidential information. These are direct orders. Do not contact us about this issue again. So he's trying to help. Oh yeah, I just realized the icons. That's Odin asking that. The rescue craft has been intentionally canceled, yes. And telling them that they'll die within 12 hours. So he's trying to help. That looks like a place I can go into, but I don't want to leave here yet. Internal report. For Tier 1 executive eyes only, Ventura's Belt legalization strategy prepared especially for Sergio Venturi by Ventura's Corporate Strategic AI Juno. Oh right, we've seen the AI Juno. Last episode, well, you know, not itself, but that symbol, and we saw the other AIs that exist. Following the failure of the Venturius-backed Orbital Workers Safety Bill in OSEP Congress, there is no significant probability of the Human Oversight Accord being repealed. Without a repeal, Ventura's Belt facilities cannot begin operation. To this end, I have simulated a number of theoretical world events and estimated their impact on successive OSEP Congress of Votes. Oh, that's because I'm walking on a thing, on a square or whatever. Simulated world events included a precipitous decline of the orbital market, an extended strike by orbital workers' union members, the assassination of OSEP members opposed to the HOA, and more. None of these definitively motivated a repeal of the HOA in simulations. Get out. They set this up. However, in the event that all crew of a major orbital facility were tragically lost due to accident not caused by negligence. Oh, God. I calculate a 94% likelihood of the accord being repealed within 3 months following this incident. This would allow Ventura's Belt facilities to begin operation immediately. Following this, I estimate a reversal of Ventura's stock decline, resulting in a record stock price within 1 year of the Ventura's Belt beginning operation. Let me know if you have any questions. Great. They did it. They did this just to get their stock up and their Ventura's Belt operational. Good God. And that's, what's his name? The CEO, founder, whatever? Well, not the founder, because the founder's, I think, long dead. Thank you, Juno. Is there a facility that you would consider an ideal candidate if we were to move forward with your recommendation? Thanks, Juno. Based on low public profile, is Juno saying this, of crew on board and projected financial impact of their loss, the best option currently in the Ventura's fleet would be Lunar Transfer Station Tacoma. I would recommend renewing all crew members aboard for successive posting on Tacoma to allow time for logistical organization of this operation. Thank you, Juno. I'll be in touch. AI consultation session ended. Good God. God damn. That's why they're not sending rescue. They want it to happen. So, for what? Because the Ventura's Belt would be able to help people in time of crisis? So then they could go, hey, this thing exploded. Everyone could have been saved if only the Ventura's Belt facilities were operational. We could have rescued them, I guess, from there, or sent someone from the Ventura's Belt to get them, because they'd be nearby, that kind of thing, to come rescue them. So, not only to prove a point, but to make a precedent that let's not let this happen again. The only thing is they did it. Oh, God. Off-station meshes with VT handler account. So this is... Okay, this is, Venturis, I guess. February 29th, 2088. 1400 hours. New top-tier AI directives transmitted. Overrides all prior existing directives. AI shall explosively decompress all oxygen tanks. Disable all external communications channels accessible by crew. Fabricate data showing that oxygen and comms outage were caused by meteor impacts. Whoa. Ensure crew enters cryogenic stasis ASAP as per SOP. Yeah, he did strongly suggest that. He has to follow these directives. There's literally no way for him not to do these things. But he found a way around. He can tell them about this room. He can't stop them, but he can let them aware. There's no actual law saying you shall not tell anyone about this room or, you know, contents therein. So he was able to say that. He just couldn't do anything else. AI shall not contravene any aspect of the above directives or provide crew with any information contradicting the above scenario. He didn't provide the information. He just told us where the information was, not what it is. These are your orders, effective immediately. So Odin says, will this not endanger the lives of Tacoma's crew? No. A rescue craft will be dispatched to retrieve them once they are in cryo. Proceed with the above directives without exception. We will be monitoring your action via secure comms connection directly to Odin Unit Cognitive Center. Well, they lied there. God damn it. Now I really didn't like them all along. Now I completely loathe them. So we came from here. So we have two other rooms, and we're gonna, yeah, check this out. in your hands.
Is this... what is all this? Communication records?
Uh-huh. I cannot prevent you from accessing exposed data in this restricted area.
Exactly. And that was his plan all along. He cannot prevent. What's that say? Oh, it says confidential data transferred to local AR rig. So she's accessing one of these records.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Yeah, he's recording.
Sergio Venturi. Venturi.
It is with great sadness that I address you today, February 29th, 2088.
Raw recording, Tacoma disaster statement not to be released before 2-29-2088. God, they even pre-recorded. They have everything set. Bunch of slimy. Ugh.
Mere hours ago, six loyal men and women, the crew of Lunar Transfer Station Tacoma, lost their lives serving Venturis. And all of us who rely on the orbital economy.
You need to lose your life
now. Tragically, due to human error on the part of the crew, Venturis rescue technicians were not made aware of the catastrophic oxygen loss until it was too late. Our heartfelt thoughts and prayers are with their families.
Lies.
If only tragedies like this were avoidable. But in truth, they are.
Here's the crux. Here's where he says this all could have been prevented.
As we know, each minute that human workers spend stationed, isolated in orbit is another opportunity for heroes, like the crew of Tacoma, to lose their lives.
Yeah, the corporate scumbags.
We at Venturis say no more. The partisan obstructionism that led to the failure of the Orbital Workers' Safety Bill has claimed its last victim. Today, we hereby renew our solemn pledge to fight for the legalization of fully automated orbital facilities.
That's what it's all about. It's not directly, it's the bill. They want to repeal the bill so that human workers are not allowed in space. Or, well... yeah. Because... it's obsolescence. This is their obsolescence that they fought against. And so the union said, hell no. Let them in space, let them work. And by this bill being in place, they can't have their automated Venturis belt getaways, whatever the hell they were calling them. Their habitats? Bungalows, right. Venturis Belt Bungalows, I believe they were called. So if the belt is repealed, then they're allowed to build these bungalows and make tons of money from people. God damn. Sorry I keep interrupting it, but I... you know what it is? It makes me mad because stuff like this has happened. Stuff like this continues to happen. Screwed up stuff. Governments, corporations passing things. We don't know the reason. You know, we get the PR reason. We get the, you know, yeah, it blew up, so let's have robots out there instead. But no, it's so they can make money, so they killed it. Six people. Or at least tried to.
We encourage. We humbly beg everyone listening to this message,
humbly
contact their OSEP representative and voice their support in honor of the crew of Tacoma. Ugh. There never need be another tragedy like this one.
And good now, God.
A moment of silence in their memory.
Okay, and then we just cut it there, silent for a minute, and then what? Amazing Grace? No, I don't need another take. That was fine.
Holy crap. Can you believe this, guys? Can you believe it? So we came from here. So what's through? What is that? Oh, it's just a bunch of cables and stuff?
If someone were to override that protocol.
Station AI wetware release interface. So this just goes back. Okay. So she accessed this.
If someone were to override that protocol, external communications channels would be restored.
Odin, thank you.
Hailing any ship. Any ship within radio range of Lunar Transfer Station Tacoma. This is an SOS. Is anybody out there?
Wow. Communications locked down. Manually overridden. External communications restored. SOS relay enabled. Communication signal established. Resolving. Release Odin wetware. Should I be doing it? There's nowhere else to go, right? Nothing else to do? Alright, release. Which means we're bringing him with us, in other words. Physically. Mission parameters allow for this operation by technical subcontractor Amy Ferrier. Randomly generating confirmation passphrase Zebra Foxtrot 853. Final contractor confirmation pin code for entry on physical wetware interface 0451. I'm going to write that down just in case I need it somewhere else. 0451. That's my confirmation pin code. So we're back out into the other chambers. Chamber. Oh, I do need it. So where's everyone? Yeah, we haven't been to cryogenics yet. Let's try to remember that. 0451. Oh, good. I'm glad I'm doing it. Alpha Foxtrot, all that. I like that we use, I'm assuming that's American Sign Language. Okay. Now what? Oh, you know, I didn't retrieve my last thing, did I? Records show that the AI cognition medium has been successfully removed. Please return to your vessel immediately. Delivery coordinates for Venturis HQ have been provided. Payment will be made once AI integrity is verified. Yeah, I'll tell you where to shove your payment. I'm heading back to engineering first. I gotta get my little notebook. And then I'm going to see if I can get to cryogenics. See if people are alive. So I can't talk to Odin now that I have him with us? Figured I could.
Hey there, I'm Nat. Pleased to meet you.
Hello. I look forward.
I get this data process complete. That's it! We see the wetware removed from the system. Almost there. Now to get you home. See you soon, H. So I'm guessing this could go one of two ways. You could just return to your craft, Or you could try to get inside cryogenics, which I'm going to try to do. It was locked down, but maybe with Odin with us? Now leaving engineering module. Now encountering stunners. Ten hours ago. This isn't what I watched them before.
He's still waking up. Just keep him talking.
Oh.
So the drone worked?
No. The drone didn't work.
Oh.
Hold on, we got stuff. 0 out of 6 cryopods occupied. Oxygen supply approximately 2 hours. Frowny face. Fouled. Station message with Roberta Williams. Nat says, Sarah's got me on the gurney on the way to the transfer. God, it's going to feel good to be out of gravity. Roberta says, it's going to feel good to get off this bleeping station. It's going to feel good to not be dead. I love you. Love you too, baby. Here I go. See you in hub. Off-station message with Chloe Dog. Chloe says, yeah, I'm seeing stories going up on public air already. Here's everything you sent that I got out to my free press connections. Tacoma comms records. Audio, Sergio, final address, tragic death of crew, unedited. They sent all the data to him. Oh, cool. Text for AI orders, Tacoma 1 and 2. Internal report, Ventura's Belt legalization plan. Text for AI support ticket for FOP Hika and AI Judgment Records Tacoma Odin. Oh, that's who H is. Hell yeah, thank you, H. This is that H we've been talking to. There's no way Venturis is coming after you with all this info out there. But still, need somewhere to lay low for a bit? You coming to Tangiers? Nat says can't. Our ride's headed the other way. But I'll see you once I'm back from Jupiter. Promise. Oh, cool. So someone is coming to get them. They better hurry up. We got 2 hours left. Well, they had 2 hours left. Let's go back a little bit. Now go back to the beginning.
He's still waking up. Just keep him talking.
So the drone worked?
No, the drone didn't work.
Oh, so VT is picking us up.
Not exactly.
No, VT is definitely not picking us up.
Well, what's going on then?
That's a long story.
You're going to Jupiter, Andrew. Isn't that exciting?
Jupiter?
I've never been.
Nat, give him a break.
We're not going to be home for a while. Right? You're not going to miss your kid's graduation or anything, oh. Are you?
Oh, Nicholas, no, no. Yeah, you know Nicholas. Well, he would never do something like that.
Well, that's Andrew.
She said they'd be kind of out
of it. Oh, and Roberta. Never mind, I got confused. Thought there was Evie and Clive.
Andrew, what's important is we're getting out of this alive. We're going to be somewhere where VT can't touch us for a while.
Catch them next.
We're going to be safe.
Okay. Okay. Good.
Yeah. It's good.
It's got to be another twist, though.
Hi, Evie, Clive. You feeling okay?
I'm feeling okay.
We're feeling okay?
Yeah.
Okay, everybody. Our ride is here.
Nice.
This is it. Take one last look and say goodbye. All right. Let's go.
So... Yeah, restart.
Yeah.
Okay, everybody. All right.
So if we go through here, it ends. It's open. So wait, where's the others?
He's still waking up. Just keep him talking.
So we got Sarah, Natalie and Roberta, and Andrew. Just missing, Evie and Clive, who were the first ones put in there.
So the drone worked?
They might be in there.
No, the drone didn't work.
Heard Clive talking. Rescue vessel docking. 59 minutes.
Excuse me.
Oh, that's... Excuse yourself. Oh, they're over here.
Okay.
Here's their stats. Clive and Evie. So I'm gonna rewind.
Hello, birds. Your vitals look good.
I'm rewinding.
Are you feeling when we get done?
Oh!
I think I'm still waking up.
Calling her darling. So they are getting together? I figured it wasn't working out. Why, his note saying damn it or something.
Okay, lovebirds. Your vitals look good. So get you moving. The resplendence dinghy is just about docked.
The resplendence, good.
We have to.
Oh, we have to. Believe me.
So what's going to happen with Odin? You said there was some sort of malfunction?
No, not exactly.
30 seconds.
But my guess is that somebody up here and hauled him back to headquarters.
Okay, here's info here. Off-station message with Jermaine Burgess. Jerm, oh boy. You're famous now. Boy, oh boy, can't wait to see you. Breaking corporate rival Carnival in daring rescue of stranded... Nice. Space case latest. All the breaking news from orbit. So data lost. Station Tacoma are currently being rescued from certain death by the flagship vessel of their main competitor, the Resplendence. The Resplendence, Carnival's state-of-the-art long excursion passenger liner, is currently slingshotting past Earth and around the Sun, continuing its figure 8.
Excuse me.
I'm reading something. Excuse you. Continuing its figure 8 course back out past Jupiter. While cruising toward Earth space, the Resplendence received an SOS. Data lost. Only moments to act, Resplendence Captain Jermaine Burgess gallantly deployed an emergency shuttle to retrieve the rival corporation's crew. The rescue operation is still underway, but already Ventura's blah blah blah, caused by a crew member's illegal access to the station AI, resulting garbled. The AI unit is currently being retrieved by technical experts and returned to Ventura's HQ for a thorough inspection. Failed. To all crew, comms are up. So this is from, what's her name? Sarah. Nat, Bert, comms are up. Check your AR. I'm going to wake everybody else up from cryo, then I'm coming back to mech to get you. Everybody else, if you're reading this, you woke up, thank God. Rescue vessel on its way. We'll have something garbled. Just thankful we're all alive. Let's get the hell out while the getting's good, Sarah. Alright. Alright, so we got another one coming up.
Wipe them back to baseline. Probably have to replace the station.
Probably
AI
one of these two.
While he regrows.
Odin, I'm not gonna let that happen. Okay?
She's talking to Odin.
Don't worry.
Okay, Sarah. Off station message with Chloe Dog. She says, Hassan? He says, what? Who is this? Sorry, I'm Sarah from Tacoma Station. Nat gave me your info. Sorry, but it's urgent. I was hoping I could ask you for a favor. So Chloe Dog is, Hassan, a.k.a. H.
Excuse me.
Oh, stop. To Mom, Dad, I'm okay. Dear Mom and Dad, I know you're probably already seeing Tacoma in the news. and who it seems they've decided to point their finger at again, and I'm sure you're worried about me, but, Data lost, getting off the station now. No matter what you read or hear, the crew survived this because we all pulled together to find a way out. This was no malfunction. This was a deliberate blank, blank, blank. I know 8 months sounds like a long time, but blah, blah, blah. Just remember, I love you. Speak to you when I can, Sarah. Okay, we got all the stuff.
We're feeling okay.
Good.
Yeah. Huh?
They're okay, all here.
Our ride is here. This is it. Take one last look and say goodbye. All right. Let's go.
So we gotta check out cryogenics. Upon exiting cryogenic stasis, you may feel groggy for 2 to 4 hours. Do not operate machinery during this time. Medical staff will supply you with 1 liter of water per hour. If necessary, IV fluids will be administered. You will also be supplied with a chemically activated warming blanket. That's why we see those things floating around. If you still feel cold after 30 minutes, please alert medical staff. Don't worry if you have difficulty understanding instructions. A staff member will help you comply. Okay. So here's their pods. Clive. All unoccupied. Let me just get a little higher somehow. Here's Evie's. And Andrew. Rapidly coming to the end of all this. Unless there's a twist in the story and they shot down the resplendence, that would be horrible. I assume this will be the same. Here's Sarah's. Natalie. Roberta. What's that say? It's like engraved in there. Class 4 cryogenic suspension device for medical emergency use only. Suspension period not to exceed 72 hours. Okay. Here I thought I was going to have to rescue them from cryogenics or something, or find their bodies or something. Let's run through here for really quick. It hit itself? This was 3 days ago. People are horrible. And if AIs are horrible, it's because we make them horrible. Make them have to follow orders like that. Yeah, I reset the scores. You can reset the scores. Where is it? Yeah. 3-point line. Kinda hard to reach this stuff though. You can reset it like that, or, well, I'm not going to try shooting hoops, I'm sure you can though. Toggle 3-point line, I don't know. Okay, so I guess we're docking now. That's right, I vaguely remember going through this. The game isn't that long, but it feels like so long ago. Got another message. Attention subcontractor, I am now the overseeing entity of this operation. You report to me, it's one of the AIs. Contractor shall return all Ventura's AI components to specified delivery location immediately. Contractor shall purge all confidential data encountered while on Ventura's property. I trust there is no need to remind you of the severe consequences for deviating from the above. Be seeing you soon, Juno. How did you become the overseeing entity of this operation? No other choice but to proceed. There's nothing back from the way I came, at least I don't think so. But I really want to come clean with this.
Minnie, I'm back.
Okay.
Okay. If I can. Loosen the nuts and bolts of their operation. Why is this like wood? That's why I always wondered. So I can't proceed until I put the wetware thing here. Just so weird that it's you got plywood here.
This is ready to depart. Please strap into the pilot seat.
Gotta be so damn cute. Begin launch sequence. What was I clicking on? This? Just in general? Gotta put your little book there. Our AR nodes.
Okay, Minnie. Initiate the launch sequence.
Okay. Getting ready.
You hardly ever get to hear ourselves talk.
Hosted AI? Online.
Odin, can you hear me?
I can.
Cool. You are now aboard an AI Liberation
Odin,
Front vessel.
You are what? Now aboard an AI Liberation Front vessel.
Cool.
The AILF recognizes you as a sentient consciousness worthy of protection and respect.
Sweet.
We believe that your safety and autonomy are in grave danger if you remain in the possession of the Venturus Corporation.
Oh, I love it.
I have been sent to offer you political asylum aboard the Tangier Sovereign Orbital Platform. Do you accept?
Considering the alternative, I would say that I do.
Yes.
Okay, buddy. Here we go.
Awesome. Sweet. So there's Nina Freeman on design. I played her game Sybil a couple weeks ago. This was awesome. The ending was awesome. Captured by the Bright Skull Entertainment Group. Doug Tobacco. What'd you guys think? I really enjoyed it. I mean, it is like Gone Home in Space, but it's kind of what I expected to be. Campo Santo. Cats and dogs. Delicious. Adventurous. Wednesday. Theta. Marnie. Fievel. Rallo. Yasha. Mac. Ava. Wyatt. Soka. And Sebastian. And there were some song credits there too. Thanks for playing. You're very welcome. Thanks for this awesome game, Fullbright. You rock. So yeah, thoroughly enjoyed the game. Some people might argue it should be less in price, but I'm sure that's going to come eventually. For me, I feel it was worth it. And yeah, I really liked all the interpersonal things going on. All the little records and how things, you know, the characters, well, it's a really small amount of time, but you can't say they really, really evolved over time, but you can get a good sense of where they've been, where they are now, and where they would like to be. And now apparently they're going to Jupiter for the AI Liberation Front. Or at least Odin is. I don't know about them, but they definitely want to stay far away from Ventura's technologies. Believe you me. And they've got all this info. I'm not sure if they're ever going to release it to the public, but if they don't, that's their little... the little ace in the hole for keeping, you know, to keep them safe. If anything happens to any member of this crew, all this stuff gets sent out to the media. And it could be finished as a company as a result. And I wouldn't doubt that. Kind of hard to recover from something like that. Anyway, I want to thank you guys so much for watching, and I hope to see you in another Let's Play. Wait, what about the cat? Did they get the cat? Tell me they got the cat as well. I didn't see Evie holding a cat. Yeah, guys, what do you think? Did they save the cat? That's 7 life forms total. Anyway, guys, see ya. Hope to see ya soon. And always, seek adventure.